How am I doing?
Just fine. You got the makings of a first-rate yodeler.
Thank you. Oh, say, I got to get back to the car and check in.
Check in?
On the radio. Come on, I'll show you.
Oh, is it all right?
Sure, come on.
Well, I reckon I hadn't better resist an officer of the law.
That's right. Just come along quietly. Remember, I've got a gun.
Uncle Jed, Granny, come quick.
What is it, General?
That policeman arrested Ma.
Arrested her?
Yes, sir. He had her by the arm, dragging her out to his police car. I'll go see if he's gone yet.
I wouldn't have called the police if I thought...
Granny, you mean you set the police on Pearl, your own kin?
I reckon I did, Jed. I don't recollect it quite clear. I guess it's because I'm so old and sick and ailing and puny and frail and all crippled up with
the rheumatism. Don't start that again. Granny, I just can't understand you turning on your own kin.
Well, it was just... It was a hot California sun that done it. That's what done it. It softened my poor old brain. You ain't gonna throw me out of the Klan, are you, Jed?
Uncle Jed! He ain't took Ma away yet. They still out front.
Maybe it's time to right the wrong you done.
Oh, I will. I will. I'll do anything. Pearl! Pearl! I'm coming, Pearl! I'm coming!
I sure wish I could invite you into the kitchen for some coffee and victuals, but Granny's so mean and cantankerous when it comes to...
Pearl! Forgive me. I'm the one that set the law on you. Please forgive me, Pearl. I'm so ashamed. Forgive me, Pearl. Don't let Jim throw me out of the Klan.
You set the law on me?
Oh, I'm low, Pearl. Awful low and mean. Step on me, Pearl. Step on me. Step on me like you would a worm. Tromp on me. Grind your feet on me. Wake me out of there. Oh, Pearl. Mr. Policeman, run over me. I don't deserve to live. Run over me and throw my poor old mean body to the buzzard.
All right, Granny, now that's enough.
But Pearl hasn't forgiven me yet. Mr. Policeman, give your gun to Pearl and let her shoot me.
Oh, Granny, stop that.
Put a curse on me, Pearl.
I forgive you. I forgive you.
But I deserve to be punished, and punished bad. Sing to me, Pearl.
Granny, Pearl done said she forgives you.
Am I taken back to the Klan? Am I welcome to the bosom of my family?
I reckon.
Pearl, you are an angel. You can have anything I got anytime. You can have any part of my kitchen. Throw me out of it. Set the dogs on me.
Take your Granny into the house, please.
Sure, Ma. Did you whomp her?
No, I didn't whomp her.
Whomp me, Pearl. Oh, Jed, I'll take him in the house. Come on in the house and whomp me, Pearl.
I'm sorry, Mr. Policeman, but Granny, you know, she gets worked up every now and then.
I understand.
Now I can invite you in the kitchen to have some victuals and coffee.
Oh, no, thanks. I see my partner coming. We better get moving.
Well, young fella, you find anything missing?
Oh, no, sir. She's got everything. I mean, everything was there. But that is around the pool.
Well, you come back and see us here.
We will. Just keep yodeling.
Bye now.
Bye.
See you when the roads get better.
Bye-bye.
It's quite a family, isn't it, Sergeant?
As you young fellas would say, like wow,
man. You know, here they are with all these millions in this big, beautiful mansion. And guess how they heat the water for their swimming pool?
How?
Well, they got this big, round kind of copper boiler, see? And coming out of the top is this kind of spout. And attached to that is this corkscrew tubing that goes down and leads into a big jar.
Right.
And they keep this fire going under this big boiler.
Officer Kelly.
But imagine how long it would take
to get all... City boy.
Yes, sir?
You have just described a still.
A what?
A still. No wonder they got so much money. These people are moonshiners.